G'day folks, Ben from Snows here. Today taking you for a walkthrough of an ultralight swag. This is the Oztent ULS-1 swag.
Hit it.
The ULS-1 swag is light on features, but it's also really light on weight, making it perfect for motorcycle tourers. So the ULS-1 swag by Oztent is made for motorcycle tourers. It's a compact swag. It's not a heap of space to move inside, but it's designed to fit comfortably in panniers or on the back of a touring motorcycle or a cross-country motorcycle. The main difference between this and other swags is it doesn't come included with a mat. So you would want to choose your own mat to go with it. And it gives you the flexibility of choosing a really lightweight mat that's going to pack up small, potentially pack up inside this with the swag, if it was say an airfield mat. Or you could pick a thicker foam mat if you like, which is going to make it a bigger pack size, but it also gives you the flexibility of packing that mat and this separately on your motorbike, so you haven't got one large sort of roll to pack somewhere. So the benefit though is it's made of really durable, high quality material. So the same material that Oztent have made all of their products with previously. This is their 8-ounce ripstop polycotton canvas. Now they don't state a waterhead rating for this on their RV tents. We've found it to be, found out details to be about 1500 millimeters, but whatever the case, I've got an RV tent and I've had that keep me dry in really wet downpours. So, no worries about waterproofness of this tent here. If you've got it set up like this, it's going to keep you dry. The bottom is a 350 GSM PVC tub floor, so even if it is set up on wet ground, this is going to keep you dry. And then there's mesh, 65 GSM, or no, actually I think it's finer than that, but a nice fine mesh panel in the top here, and also vents in the ends. So a combination of all the quality materials that Oztent have always used in all of their products, just in a nice compact swag this time. It's single skin, so there's no inner and outer. The only double section is this and the spot underneath that. We'll go into a bit more on that shortly. Now the poles, there's not many poles in it. You've got this hoop pole here. This is anodized aluminium. At the foot end, there is a small anodized aluminium upright pole as well. And there's also a small fiberglass pole that's kind of built into the tent to give it some structure and stability. Having a walk around the outside of the tent, we'll start at this end, and I'll use this opportunity also to point out the lightweight aluminium pegs. They're tri-pegs that come with the tent. So this has kind of got that hiking feel about it. So they're not heavy duty steel pegs, they're lightweight aluminium pegs to save a bit of weight, which is what you're looking for motorcycle touring. You've got this vestibule over the end here with a bit of a vent up here. So this goes up to a mesh panel up the top here. I'll just take this off of the peg here to show you underneath. So a bit of storage, this comes about 50 centimeters out to this point here. So you could store a bit of stuff under here. It's gonna have, if it's really wet and windy, things are gonna get wet, but you've got this little sort of flap of fabric here, which it doesn't secure up here or anything. I think it might've been put there to be able to secure these straps, which are used to roll it away so you can't lose them. They have just made it slightly larger so that you can actually put things on top of it. So if it's wet ground or muddy ground, you've got a dry spot to put things on top of. And then you've got this mesh panel in here. No zips or anything, you can't access that from inside the tent. That's purely there for ventilation. And then this big awning sits over the top of that for weather protection, comes down nice and low. So you get good ventilation with lots of protection with the rain. Moving back around this side of the tent, I might go right down to the foot end of the tent to start with before we crawl inside. This is, I guess, not really a vestibule, just a tab over the top here with this little pole that I talked about before. It's got a little foot on the bottom to stop it sinking into soft ground. That just gives this end of it a bit of height because there's no poles in the sides here. There is a little spreader pole across the top here just to give a bit more foot space. And then up underneath that, there is a small, can't quite see it from here, but you can see just here, a small vent to allow a bit of ventilation. So you get ventilation from both ends of the swag. Nothing more to see at this end, just the guy rope to hold it all in place. But if we move back here to the where you get in and out of the tent, pretty simple. So if you're looking for something with a door on the side that you can sit at on the side of and kind of have breakfast, then this is probably not quite the design you're after, because it's just got a small opening on the top here. Now this is all, like I said, it's made to be compact and lightweight. So it doesn't have all the extra awning features and doors and access points that a lot of swags will have. It's just got this one entry point on top here. So we can fold this back. This gives us ventilation at the top. So if it's a warm night, we've got that ventilation at the head end, ventilation at the feet, ventilation through the top here, and we can see the night sky. If it's really wet, then we zip this up and we've still got ventilation at each end. We undo this. We can also roll this up. There's another tab under there, so we can secure this here if we want. So if we're not the type to get eaten up by mozzies, and we want to just sleep in the open sky or with everything open above us, you can just lie in there like that at night. Now you can see there's no mat inside here. It's just that heavy duty PVC base floor. So in terms of a mat to fit in here, you've got 210 centimeters of length. So more than enough than what you'd need for a lightweight hiking mat to fit in. So it tapers from about 70 centimeters in width, at the head end here, and down to 50 centimeters at the foot end. So those three dimensions, 210, 70 down to 50, are well within what you need to fit a lightweight hike mat in there. And if you get one of those air filled mats, they puff up to sort of 5 to 8 centimeters in thickness, but they're packed down really small. You can actually roll that up inside this swag here and probably still get it back in the bag. If you want to get a foam mat though, something thicker, it's just going to be a little bit bulkier. The alternative is to be able to pack your swag and your mat separately, which might work better for your pannier setup anyway. So plenty of space to fit a mat inside, but just be aware it doesn't come with a mat. Get yourself a good quality mat anyway. Now I'm gonna crawl inside. There's not a lot of space in here. It's certainly claustrophobic in terms of how swags traditionally feel for space. It's almost like a bivy sack, a heavy duty bivy sack, I suppose. Now I'm 185 centimeters in height. I've got reasonably broad shoulders, so I can feel like if I sit up here, the fabric is against my shoulders here. So comfortable to sit up like this if I like. I guess I've got space to eat here if I wanted to sit inside my sleeping bag while I'm inside here still. But not a lot of wiggle room, but it certainly is going to achieve its job in terms of giving me shelter. So I'll slide down in the tent. Now I've got big size 12 feet as well, so I've got them upright in the end here at the moment. So they're just touching the top there. So you want to make sure you have good ventilation. If it's a really cold night, just be aware of condensation inside the tent. Being a single skin tent, you might get that condensation build up inside the actual tent. If I lie down here now and I'm going to disappear right inside the swag, I've got heaps of space in terms of length. So plenty of head space here. My feet, I can't see. Well, I can see my feet, but they sit upright quite comfortably in the end of the tent there, right where there's a vent. I can wiggle them around. They're not touching the side, so I don't know if we can see inside the tent there to the end, how my feet fit at the end. But I don't feel claustrophobic. Height-wise, I mean, I'm not claustrophobic anyway, but I don't feel too crammed in. It's about 60 centimeters of head height here. So once this is done up over the top, I can't sit up, but I've got room to roll around, I suppose. My shoulder is still within the height of this here. If I've got a bulky sleeping bag on it, it might sort of rub the top a little bit. So it's certainly not made for heaps of space inside the tent, but there's enough to keep you dry if you do a motorcycle touring and you're trying to fit that lightweight or balance the lightweight with durability. Other features inside the tent here, there is a mesh pocket on the side here, so you can keep things at hand so they don't get lost during the night. But that's pretty much it. There's no power access points. There's no lantern hanging points or anything like that. They've really stripped it down to try and keep it nice and lightweight. Nothing more to see at the end. I mean, the end is actually quite good for foot space. I've slept in envelope style swags before where your feet feel a bit cramped, but this actually does feel pretty good for foot space with that extra pole at the end there. So I'd say it offers pretty good space, and it's quite a good balance for motorcycle tourists who are perhaps looking for something that's maybe more durable than a hike tent, a little bit simpler to set up than a hike tent. They're not looking for something that they can sit in and play games or bunker down in for nights upon end. They just want something that is a shelter they can pull up, peg it out, crawl into, stay dry and warm for the night, and pack it up nice and easy the next morning. But that is a run through of the Oztent Ultralight Swag 1 from Oztent, an ultralight single skin, easy setup, all in one swag for motorcycle touring that is going to give you years and years of use because it's made with really durable materials. If you can check them out online, it's snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you do have any questions or comments, let us know down below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other cool Oztent swags like these ones down here.